get the car up to temperature on this lap, please. We're learning the... Gears, so let's go through them all if you can. Superb parking there, mate. Let's make sure we get the edge on the surrounding drivers as the lights go out. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid is formed. 10 to 15 minutes. Nice move. Keep going. Okay, gap ahead is 3.1 seconds. We'll be right back. slow slip. These conditions are making the line a bit greasy, but we're still nowhere near the changeover point. Making another pit stop. For you. Right, they've got a serious car issue. It looks like they're retiring. 20 minutes of light rain. Dropping back by about 3/10 a lap. Well done. Trailing the car ahead by 5.2 seconds. Okay, let's see if we can catch the car ahead. Gap currently 5 seconds. mate. I cannot complain about that one. That was an excellent drive. Well done.
A great race then, and a fantastic victory here at Albert Park. So, Natalie, what do you think helped them deliver this result?
Quite simply, a driver is nothing without the team behind them. So, a deserved winner, but we do have to give a shout out to the team in the pit lane and back at the factory. Very much a collaborative process.
The drivers are en route to the podium as we speak. What a fantastic win for the Red Bull team. They've performed exceptionally today, keeping us firmly on the edge of our seats throughout the entirety of the race. Congratulations to everybody at the team. Let's review the driver's standings. Max Verstappen now leads the Drivers' Championship. So then, Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Often, my go-to would be a driver who's managed to pull off an especially impressive feat during the race. However, in this instance, I was more impressed by Max Verstappen's solid, clean driving throughout the event.
Let's move on to the